selection process.
When the CLAT results come out, the next stage, which involves counseling of the candidates, is basically allotment of the colleges. So basis the preference which student has given while applying the CLAT, applying for the CLAT in the particular year, and according to the rank which the student has got after the performance in the examination, the student will be allotted a particular college based on these two factors. It will be up to the student whether he wants to take admission in that particular NLU or not. A student will have three choices in the second stage of the selection process. The first one, the NLU which has been allotted to him, he locks it and goes for admission over there. The student will also have a choice to upgrade to the higher NLU basis the preference which he has given during the application process. If the student is not satisfied with the score this year and does not want to take admission this year, he also has a choice to withdraw from the admission process. The entire process, entire second stage is basically online. Once the colleges are locked, once the admission process gets over, then only the students would be required to go to the respective NLUs and complete the formalities. In LSAT, the situation is very different. While applying for the LSAT examination, a student is required to give choices for the five colleges in which he wants to take the admission. But there are other colleges which also gives calls to the student based on the performance in the examination. If you have more than 50 percentile in the LSAT examination, most of the colleges will give you a call, and then you will have to go through a second round of selection process which might involve interview or group discussion.
College Deku wishes you all the very best for the upcoming exam. If you like this video, please like, share, comment and subscribe to our YouTube channel.